keeping with the same themes, we saw another antibody that's been part of our practice, bevacizumab, for years in non-small cell, non-squamous non-small cell. A very interesting trial from the French, the Mesothelioma trial, in which there was a clear survival advantage. Mary Jo, what you want to walk us through that?
It was a randomized trial of standard chemotherapy for mesothelioma with cisplatin and pemetrexed, and the randomization was to add bevacizumab. And it met its survival endpoint with a median survival reaching over the one-year mark. I consider it a positive trial and I would use it. I find it interesting for a couple of reasons. One is its movement in a disease that hasn't had a lot of progress in several years.
Well, much like squamous,
and,
right? Yeah.
And the second thing, most of the non-small cell lung cancer data with bevacizumab, if it's helping, it seems to be helping when you have it with a taxane backbone. Maybe there's some angiogenic synergism with the taxanes, but the data not including the taxane has been less impressive with pemetrexed, with the European AVAIL trial. So this drug reached its endpoint, and maybe the angiogenic pathway is much more important in mesothelioma.
Is this an advance, Naiyer, in your opinion?
Absolutely. I mean, I think that you know, that meso is such a, you know, tough disease to treat, and I think that you know, having you know, a phase three trial that met its survival endpoint, I think is very real, and I think it's changes practice.
Yeah, I don't remember in the study. I don't know if they reported what percentage of the mesothelioma population would be eligible to receive Bev. You know, there are lots of reasons
That's a good
not to
point.
Give Bev.
The
I don't
overall
know.
survival was more impressive, though, in this phase three trial than in the last phase three trial, the vogelsang trial. Like, we're doing better for this
Yeah.
disease. I'm not quite sure why that was. I was
Well,
impressed
that may
by
be,
everyone did
yeah,
better.
that may be, you know, if you exclude half your patients,
Maybe
because
selection.
I mean, it may be the better patients that you're looking at, but I don't remember that.
Right, the
number.
Tissue type, for example, you know.
The histologic subtype is
Yeah.
a key biomarker, right. I do wonder if pemetrexed maintenance alone might be a good enough, you know, therapeutic option for mesothelioma. A lot of, if you look at the curves, a lot of the difference was after the sort of six cycles time point when those on Bev maintenance did well and those without maintenance therapy on the control arm did less well. And so there's a study looking at a cis-pem with or without pem maintenance for mesothelioma in the CLGB alliance that may move the bar in a similar way.
Yeah,
There,
I'm sorry, Roy, go ahead.
I was just going to ask, are there any other genetic, you know, genetically targeted drugs for mesothelioma?
PI3 kinase has been explored.
Right.
mTOR inhibitors have been unsuccessful.
Yeah.
We're involved in an nintedanib trial in meso, kind of the same design as the Bev trial, you know, plus minus phase two.
FAK inhibitor I've seen.
Yes.
So
Yeah.
there's some stuff happening, but there have been a lot
But
of negative
it's
trials.
been, yeah.
Given how many negative trials there have been, it is impressive that
That's
this
my
one
point.
Succeeded.
Yeah. Yeah.
Is getting back to Jeff's point, do the panelists typically practice maintenance therapy in their meso patients, or are you more? I'm kind of a four cycle guy, and they, you know, they either respond or they don't, and I kind of give them a break from therapy. We have the trial, the Alliance trial, open, so we try to put people on that trial to kind of get some data, but I just wonder what other people are doing.
Usually four cycles and then watch, you know, think about surgery if they're a candidate either for a pleurectomy or, dare I say it, an extrapleural
Don't say
procedure.
it.
I haven't done one of those since I left Boston.
Yeah.
But then, you know, look for trials, and immunotherapy's actually had some
Right.
Headway here
Yeah,
too.
We'll get back
We're
to
all
that.
lung cancer docs, but in every other cancer, you don't stop chemo. I don't stop chemo on mesothelioma.
Yeah.
Right? If they get toxic, you drop the platinum, and I continue the chemo, just like for breast cancer and for colon cancer and other cancers.